Today, let us discuss about the subdivisions of posterior triangle and also the contents of posterior triangle. So, as we have already discussed the boundaries of posterior triangle, inferior belly of the omohyoid muscle basically divides the posterior triangle into occipital triangle and supraclavicular triangle. Supraclavicular triangle is also called subclavian triangle. So we are going to discuss the contents of occipital triangle. Later we will discuss the contents of supraclavicular triangle. In this diagram I have shown some contents of posterior triangle. As you can see that anteriorly posterior triangle is bounded by the sternocleidomastoid muscle, posteriorly posterior triangle is bounded by trapezius muscle, and inferiorly clavicle is present. So first of all, let us discuss the contents of occipital triangle. As you can see in the diagram, that spinal accessory nerve emerges a little above the middle of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Then it descends laterally and pierces the deep fascia and finally disappears behind the anterior border of the trapezius muscle. Four cutaneous nerves can also be seen in the occipital triangle. These are lesser occipital nerve having the root value of C2, greater auricular nerve having the root value of C2, C3, anterior cutaneous nerve or transverse cutaneous nerve having the root value of C2, C3, and supraclavicular nerves, medial, intermediate, and lateral supraclavicular nerves having the root value of C3 and C4. These four cutaneous nerves, they pierces the deep fascia and become superficial. In the occipital triangle, there are also some muscular branches, like two small branches are given to levator scapulae. As you know that levator scapulae muscle is present in the floor of the posterior triangle. Two small branches are also given to trapezius muscle and nerve to rhomboideus muscle. We can also see that C5-6 roots of the brachial plexus are also seen in the contents of the posterior triangle. Occipital artery, which is a branch of the external carotid artery, can be seen at the apex of the posterior triangle. It passes superficial to the splenius capitis muscle. Transverse cervical artery, which is a branch of the thyrocervical trunk, can also be seen in the occipital triangle. Transverse cervical artery crosses the scalene anterior muscle, upper trunks of the brachial plexus, scalene medius muscle, and finally divides into superficial and deep branches. Now let us discuss the contents of supraclavicular triangle or subclavian triangle. As you can see in the image and in the diagram, that supraclavicular triangle has three trunks of brachial plexus, upper, middle, and lower trunk of the brachial plexus. In this diagram, I have also drawn three trunks of brachial plexus, upper, middle, and lower trunk of the brachial plexus. And secondly, supraclavicular triangle also contains nerve to serratus anterior muscle. Nerve to serratus anterior muscle has the root value of C5, C6, C7. It passes behind the brachial plexus. It descends in front of the serratus anterior muscle and gives branches to this muscle. Nerve to subclavius muscle having the root value of C5, C6 that arises from the upper trunk of the brachial plexus can also be seen in the supraclavicular triangle. Nerve to subclavius descends in front of the brachial plexus, in front of the subclavian vessels, and finally reach deep to the subclavius muscle. Suprascapular nerve that arises from the upper trunk of the brachial plexus having the root value of C5, C6 can be seen in the lower part of the posterior triangle. It passes behind the omohyoid muscle, finally supply the muscles that are present on the scapula. These are supraspinatus and infraspinatus muscles. So suprascapular nerve basically innervates supraspinatus, infraspinatus muscles of the scapula. Third part of subclavian artery and subclavian vein can also be seen in the supraclavicular triangle. Over here I have drawn third part of the subclavian artery. commencement of transverse cervical artery and vein can also be seen in the supraclavicular triangle. Lower part of the external jugular vein can also be seen in the supraclavicular triangle. We have already discussed its course in our previous lectures. Some lymph nodes are also present in the posterior triangle, as you can see in the image, that along the posterior border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle, posterior superficial cervical chain is present. Just above the clavicle, supraclavicular lymph nodes are present, and occipital lymph nodes are also found in the posterior triangle.